Hi, this is Swati. Welcome to my channel Star Seed Flower. Today in this video, we will learn about the conversion of fractions into decimal. This is a typical form of fractions and we are convert these fractions into decimal form. This is the decimal form of the given fraction. So we convert these fractions into decimal by two different methods. First, we see the general method or the typical or convenient method to get these decimals. Let's get start to know about the first method of getting these decimals. As you already know about that, the fractions are in the numerator or the denominator form. It also means that we have to divide the 9 with 6. The denominator is also the divisor and the numerator is dividend. So we just divide the numbers by getting the possible divisibilities, and then after that we get the remainder 0. And the quotient is our decimal form of that fraction. In this method, we have to divide the numbers until we get the remainder 0. For that, we have to add the decimal point and add zeros in this method to get decimal form of that fraction. In the second method, in this we have to convert the denominator with any power of 10. Or even if the fraction is equivalent, the fraction's denominator is equivalent to make the power of 10. If it has a conversion, then we use this type of method to make the decimals. Just two things we have to know about that. What is power of 10? 10's any power, that is 1, 2, 3, that is 10, 100, 1000 and many more powers. The second thing we have to know that what is equivalent to the given fraction. With an example, if the denominator of any fraction is 8, then we have to multiply it with 125, that 8 has the capability to make 1000 by multiplying with 125. Get the 10's third power with 8. Let's take an example of to get more understand about this method. In this, the denominator is 4. For that, we have to multiply it with 25. 4 multiplied with 25 gets 100, the 10's second power. One thing you also know that the numerator is also divided with the same number that we multiplied in the denominator to make it balance. Then after that we get the fraction, that is 175 by 100. Then its decimal form is 1.75. Whenever we divide any number with 100, the decimal point gets after the two digit from the right side. Let's see the second example. In this, the denominator is 25 and we know that the 25 multiplied with 4 gets 100. We have to see the least possible power of 10th, that is 100. We get 100, we also get the 1000, but we have to get the least possible power of 10, and in this we get the 100 and we get the decimal form of that fraction, that is 2.76. I think you understand this method of converting fractions into decimal. By both these usable methods, we have to use both the methods. It depends on the given fractions.